Hi, my name is Greg Orr. You can call me Dr. Go. Today we're at the Healing with Horses Ranch to introduce you to the Fujitsu Lifebook T937 tablet. We're going to look at the top 10 items you want to know before you saddle up and take the reins. The new T937 is slightly different from the T936 that some of our agency staff are already using. You can see the older one is silverish and the new one is black. The differences go deeper than that, so make sure you're taking the correct training for your device. Top item number one, this is a workhorse. The T937 is light, but it's got a 13.3-inch screen, a lot of computing power, and a solid reliability record. It's a road warrior's dream machine. Top item number two, the power-on slide switch. You'll notice the power-on slide switch is a little different. It's located at the bottom right of the screen. Slide it forward and let go. After a few seconds, you should see the login screen. Sliding the power button switch while it's on puts it to sleep. When it's asleep, slide the power-on button again to wake it up. To shut it down, use Windows to go through the regular log-off and shutdown process. Top item number three. Configurations. The Fujitsu T937 is a small computer, but there are lots of ways you can use it. Laptop mode. As soon as you open it, you can use it just like a laptop. This works great on a table or on your lap. Tablet mode. You can swivel the screen and fold it flat to use it as a tablet. When you set it up as a tablet, it will ask if you want Windows to automatically transition to tablet mode. To avoid damaging the screen during storage, turn it off, return the computer to laptop mode, and close the cover. Here we have it set up in desktop mode. You can see the T937 Lifebook is connected to the dock through a USB-C connection. That connection carries power, video, LAN, USB, sound, and just about everything in one connection. Since a desktop keyboard is attached, we pivoted the keyboard behind the screen. We also have an extended monitor and a mouse. Top item number four, internet connectivity. For Wi-Fi, you can mouse over that indicator to see which wireless network you're connected to. You can toggle the wireless off and on with the F5 key. The Lifebook is so thin, you can't fit a LAN Ethernet connection into it. So, to connect a LAN cable, you have to use your fingernail to pull the LAN adapter out and expand it. Now, the adapter looks like it could break easily, but it's actually very strong. Our IT people tested it and found it's flexible, not flimsy. Even so, treat it gently like you would any LAN connection, and it should work fine. If it does break, call in a ticket and get it fixed. Top item number five, keyboard and touchpad. The keyboard has 85 keys, and the size and spacing of the keys are the same as a full-size keyboard. The top of the keyboard has what they call hot keys. The main difference between hot keys and most F keys is, by default, hot keys do whatever is on the image. You can see F3 and F4 are volume up and down. Press one or the other to control your volume. If you want to use the hot keys as function keys, let's say F11 to maximize your browser. Press the function button and the F key. If you're one of our mobile staff who have to enter a lot of numbers, press the numlock hot key and you have a virtual numbers keypad. You can backlight the keys. Press the function button and the space bar to toggle keyboard backlighting between low, high, and off. Some portable computers have a touchpad with kind of virtual left and right mouse buttons. The T937 left and right mouse buttons are separate, physical buttons, so you'll know for sure when you're clicking them. Top item number six, the stylus. The stylus has a built-in battery that recharges when it's inserted at the front of the computer. DFPS field staff who tested it say it's very intuitive and smooth. When you insert the stylus, make sure that you insert it with the charging contacts pointed toward the keyboard. It will fully recharge in 5 minutes. Top item number 7, screen visibility. Pressing the hotkeys F7 and F8 will increase or decrease screen brightness. In tablet mode, the Lifebook screen will rotate automatically depending on how you're holding it. If you don't want it to rotate, swivel and fold the screen to tablet mode, select Fujitsu Function Manager, and disable auto rotate. The resolution is set pretty high. If you need those icons to be just a little bigger, you can right-click on the home screen, select Display Settings, and change the resolution. Top item number 8, screen swivel. By screen swivel, we mean the actual physical turning of the screen from laptop to tablet and all the possible angles in between. The manual from the manufacturer says to use 2 hands when rotating the screen. So use 2 hands and take it slowly until you get used to how it feels and never force it. Top item number 9, power management. You can charge the T937 3 ways. Plug it into the wall adapter and the status should show that it's charging. You can also connect the dock to the USB-C port. Always make sure the dock is powered on by the power indicator light. You also get a car charger that allows you to charge it from the cigarette lighter in a car. The battery is designed to last for up to 10 hours of use. I've found the amount of time varies depending on how many applications I have running and whether I'm using my iPhone as a hotspot. We don't get backup batteries, but we do get a car charger. Even so, remember to charge it every night. As a best practice, follow the power conservation measures in the user guide. If you click the battery icon on your Windows taskbar, you can extend your battery life by clicking Battery Saver or reducing your screen brightness. Top item number 10, what can I attach to it? Let's go around the Lifebook and take a quick look at the ports. Starting in the upper left and going counterclockwise, we have the power supply. Next to that is the security lock device. This is the USB port, and next to that is your headset microphone combination jack. In the front, we have status indicator lights. Over on the right side, still going counterclockwise, there is a stylus slot and the attachment eye for the stylus tether. There's a memory card slot and a USB port with a charging function. If you're going to charge your DFPS cell phone from your computer, this is the best port to use. There is a USB-C port with charging function and an HDMI port. You can also see the LAN connection that was demonstrated earlier and a VGA port. Last but not least, you get a dock that can attach several more USBs, video output options, power, and sound. Well, it's about time to put the chairs in the wagon. Remember to download and reference the user guide. This is Dr. Go with the Fujitsu Lifebook Top 10, wishing you happy trails.